Okay, as we continue, so we have to identify also the location of this zero shear. So you can identify, you can call this as X. So X would be the reaction at point B1 over 37.8, and that is equal to 1.196. So as mentioned, we have to identify our maximum moment. So we get try to identify the moment, you try to draw the moment diagram so that you can identify the value at the moment of point A and point E. Or if you don't want to draw the moment diagram, you can have this equation so that you can have the value of the moment at point A and at point E. So once you identify the magnitude on the zero shear, so we try to compare our maximum moment, of course, at point E. So this is the maximum moment, which is 27.03. Since we have identified our maximum moment, you can compute for the section modulus of the sheet pile, which is maximum moment over the allowable flexural stress. And that gives us, we are given with the allowable flexural stress 170 times 10 to the third. So that gives us now 15.9 times 10 to the negative 5 cubic meter per meter of the wall. Then the last one, we have to identify the reaction at level B. So we have computed the reaction at level B, so we can compute for the maximum moment. So the maximum moment at point B is 101.7 kilonewton per meter. So therefore, you can have the value for the section modulus, which is equal to 0.598 times 10 to the negative 3 cubic meter per meter of the wall. So this is the reaction, the maximum moment at point B. So this is our section modulus at point B. So we have now the bottom heap of cut in a clay. So for this one, base cuts in clay may become unstable as a result of heaving at the bottom of the excavation. So when you talk about heaving, that is the heaving, the ground heave is the upward movement. So heaving is an upward movement of the ground usually associated with the expansion of clay soil, which swells when wet. So as the soil generally cannot expand downward or sideways, the result is that the exposed upper surface of the soil rises up. So that is basically the concept of heaving, that is the upward movement of the soil on the due to the expansion of the clay soil. According to Terzaghi, analyzed the factor of safety of long braced excavations against bottom heave. The failure surface for such a case in homogeneous soil is shown in this figure. So this is the failure surface of the homogeneous soil. So that's one. In the figure, the following notations are used. We have your B prime or B, which has the width of the cut, which is our H, the depth of the cut. T is our thickness. That's one. Thickness of the clay below the base of the excavation. And Q is the uniform, this is our Q, uniform source charge adjacent to the excavation. The ultimate bare capacity of the base of a soil column with width of B prime can be given as we have this equation, ultimate bearing capacity is equal to C n sub C. Of course, our n sub C is 5.7 for perfectly rough condition. The vertical load per unit area along Q is equal to gamma times H plus Q minus C times H all over B prime. And our factor of safety against bottom heave is equal to this equation, ultimate bearing capacity over the surcharge. For excavation of limited length L, the factor of safety can be modified to this equation. And B prime is equal to T or b all over the square root of 2, whichever is smaller in value, that is the equivalent value for b prime. So in 2000, Chang suggested the revision of the modified factor of safety. So this is now the modified factor of safety as suggested by Chang. So our b prime is equal to t, which is if t is less than or equal b all over the square root of 2. Or b prime could be equal to b all over the square root of 2 if t is greater than b all over the square root of 2. And b double prime is equal to the square root of 2b prime. In homogeneous clay, if Fs becomes less than 1.5, the sheet pile is driven deeper. Usually, the depth d is kept less than or equal to b all over 2, in which the case, the force p per unit length of the buried sheet pile, which is a prime and b b prime, may be equivalent to this equation. So this is the force acting on this buried portion of the sheet pile. So this is for d, which is greater than 0.47b, and b would be equal to this equation if d, this is the d that we're talking about, if d is less than 0.47 of b. So for the stability of the bottom of cut in sand, so the bottom of cut in sand is generally stable. When the water table is encountered, the bottom of the cut is stable as long as the water level inside the excavation is higher than the groundwater level, in case dewatering is needed. The factor of safety against piping should be checked. So piping is another term for failure by heave. So piping may occur when a high hydraulic gradient is created by water flowing into excavation. So there is another term for the failure of heave, which is piping. To check the factor of safety, draw flow net and determine the maximum exit gradient that we look for at points A and B. So we have here our forces for this for a cut in sand. P is just equal to this equation when D is greater than 0.47B, and P is equal to this equation when D is less than 0.47B. So our A is the length of the flow element at A or at B, and D is the number of drops. Of course, you are familiar with the flow net. This is used to compute, actually it's a graphical representation if you wanted to get the if there is a two-dimensional flow of water. So we try to illustrate that so that we can compute for the discharge. For two-dimensional flow of water, we try to illustrate that and use the concept of flow net. So the factor of safety against piping can be expressed by this equation, which is this is the critical hydraulic gradient. And the critical hydraulic gradient is equal to this equation. So the magnitude of critical hydraulic gradient is between 0.9 and 1.1 in most soil, with an average of about 1. A factor of safety of about 1.5 is desirable. So basically, that ends for our flow for brace cuts, which is basically, brace cuts is a structure that is being installed to support an excavated area to prevent the movement of the soil within the perimeter of the excavated area. So, brace cuts can either be a solar beam or a sheet pile. So that ends our discussion for brace cuts.